Hello team, today I am going to explain you regarding the HQ supermarket some features, the basic features. So this video is related to supermarket learning program. So first one is before starting any transaction or any master creation, the first settings we need to do, that is under the admin configuration, this is setup configuration settings. So this settings, this is the HQ settings. You can do all kind of HQ settings from this screen. So first setting is, that is tax configuration. So we know in India GST is available, but other than India, other countries VAT is available. So who are the countries using VAT? We can give here VAT. So this is very much necessary before starting any masters or creating any masters or doing any transactions. This is very much essential. So you can see here the transaction configuration, you cannot change it, change also in later. So by default it will be VAT. So carefully we have to enable this configuration, right? So second one, I'm just going to explain you regarding the GST master. So what is GST master? GST master is nothing but GST tax percentage. So in India, what are the GST percentages available? So you can see here by default. So in case any GST percentage newly added by the government and it is not available here, do not panic. So whatever the GST percentage will be added, it will be added by the our product team, and it will be available in the next release. So this is the reason in GST master we have not given the you cannot create the GST tax percentage. Now I am just going to explain you, this is MDM, this is master data management. So under this tax master management, next one is HSN master. So in GST mode, each product type, the government has announced the HSN code. So you can see here, this is the HSN master. Is this HSN master, you can create the new HSN code. You can go down and you can do from the Excel sheet also, copy paste from here also. So you can give any GST, any HSN code. You can map this HSN code belongs to which GST tax percentage, you can give here, and you can give the descriptions. So what kind of product this is. And you can make it active and save it. So old HSN master also you can make it inactive. So just save it. And now this HSN code will be available in the item master. You can map this. Now tax master management. Now this is very much important. The country who is not managing the GST, where VAT is managed, so you have to create the tax percentage also. So just click here. So this is nothing but a VAT master. Just click here, add. You can choose the tax type, that is VAT. You can give the tax description. So you can give here what is the tax percentage. So just VAT percentage 14, and just you can save it. Or that country, if it is required, the C form, excise due to excise tax percentage or whatever. So you can also give the required things and you can save it. So next one is VAT area master. When VAT was available in India, so like under one country, under the India, each state have the different VAT percentages for the product. So in such cases, you can create the VAT area master also. Just click on the add. You can give the area name. And save it. So in this way, you can create the multiple VAT area. Now this VAT area will be available in the outlet master. When you are creating the outlet master, just I will explain you when I'll go there. So just we can refresh this page, so it will be available. So now it is loading. So after the VAT area master, the most important is like you have to map the tax percentage each area wise. So that is called VAT commodity master. So like one product, in example, we can say the example, like one product in West Bengal, it is 14%. Same product in Tamil Nadu, that is 2%. So this is called different VAT percentage for the same product. So same you can manage from the VAT commodity list. So just click here, you can select the VAT area master. So you can give the commodity code. So just remember the select area. It will show you the area which you have already mapped in the outlet master. If you have not mapped in the outlet master, it will not show you the area. So you can give the commodity code. So commodity code should be every time unique. So we can give the unique code. And so this is, I'm just going to map the VAT 14%. So you can give the descriptions. You can give the schedule type. And we can give the part also. And you can give the tax percentage. It means for Tamil Nadu, what are the tax you are going to use? So first one, you are going to use like VAT 14%. Second, if in Tamil Nadu available 2% also, so you can give the 2% also, 1%, 0%, like that you can map. It means in Tamil Nadu 5% is not available, you don't have to map here. So each tax percentage why you have to map the VAT commodity master. This is very much important. Now just I'm going to explain the outlet master. So this is, before that I will also explain you one more things, that is under the tax master management, this is tax registration master. This is nothing but each company have the GST number, so you have to give the GST details. Just I will explain you how. So when you add here, so you can give the GST number here. You can give the company name here, and you can give the address info, city, for telephone number, you can save it. So now when you go to the outlet master, this GST number, it will show. So I'm just going to the outlet info. Now when you are creating any outlet, so now while creating the outlet, you can see the GST percentage here. Just the page is loading. So when you're creating the new outlet, you can give the outlet name here. You can select here the your edition. So what the edition is available. So due to order is not available, it will not allow. So we have to edit only. Can show you in the edit mode only. So you can see here, the GST percentage, whatever we have mapped there. So you can see here, and one more point is there. Last, this is the VAT area master. So if any customer using the VAT, you have to give the correct area master. That is VAT area master. So the outlet which you are creating here. So if you are creating, let's say for example, for Tamil Nadu outlets, so you have to give the Tamil Nadu here. So now moving to the next, I'll show you the item master. So MDM, item master management. This is item master. So just we are creating. I just going to edit and just going to give you the overview. Right. So here, now in the item master, so what are the options available? Just I'm going to explain. So here you can give the item name and you can give the sort name here. So this is a manufacturer name. You can give here, you can create from here also clicking by new. Same the main supplier, you can give the new, you can select the supplier name here by giving the space bar. So it will show you all the supplier list. You can choose from here. If it is not available, you can create then and there by clicking new button. So you can give the category and section, brand, the what are the categories available, you can give here. So you can give the GST HSN percentage. So you can choose here the HSN percentage. So based on this, automatically that GST code, the GST tax percentage will come automatically. You can give the GST UM, that is for the GST filing, it will be good. So you can give here the EN code. So you can give the multiple EN code also. So this is good option, that decimal points. So if any items is vegetable items, so you can give the decimal here so that you can sell like 1.25 kg, like that you can, it will allow you to sell. So here the item preparation is status. So here the item which you are creating here, you can give like a trade as is. You can give the bulk items, repackage, parent or child, assembly and kit. So this kind of options available, the item preparation status. You can choose the status and you can create the items. So suppose you are going to create the repackage items, like bulk repackage items. So if you give the repackage, it will ask you to give the bulk item name. So whatever the item name you have created under the bulk, so it will be available here. You can choose and you can give the item name as well. Like this item name is available by like 250 grams. So you can give the here grams here. So this is repackage, and here you can give the SKU type is very much important for the supply for HU customers. So put away, that is the items which are stored in the warehouse. So that is called put away items. Flow through, is that is completely moving. So normally it is not stored in the warehouse, but it is purchased through the warehouse. So like a FMCG product. And DSD item that is called direct store delivery items. So it means the items like milk or bakery products directly purchased through the by the local supplier or by the outlet, you can mark these as a DSD items. Right. So you can also, this is a good option, allow loyalty. You can mark it yes or no, you can mark it. So this is the item master, and here you can mark the item inclusive of tax, yes or no, you can mark here, and you can give the purchase rate, MRP, selling rate. And one more point is here, like batch and expiry. So you can mark the items like batch and expiry is mandatory for the items. So if it is day base, you can mark like a day base, like if you want to mark the expiry based on the day base, so you can mark the day base, or not required, you can give the not required. So batch confirmation also you can give the as per your required customer requirement. So you can also mark the allow sales return. So if you mark it allow sales return, so it will allow the return, otherwise it will not allow the sales return. So next one is for the wettable items, you can mark wettable yes or no, you can mark it here. And for wettable items, so you can mark the by unit or by weight, you can also mark. Maintain selling MRP. This is also very good option for item master, item properties. So multiple selling and multiple MRP, if items having the selling different selling rate and different MRP, so you can maintain this multiple selling, multiple MRP. If like vegetable kind of items, you can maintain the same selling, same MRP. And so say single selling and multiple MRP also you can maintain. So this is gatekeeper margin. So if a product like if you give the 10% for this item, so 10% margin is fixed, so it will help you while doing the purchase. So this is the common options available. So after giving the all purchase rate, and this is not mandatory to give the purchase rate, selling rate, but you can give, and then just give the add, and you can update it here, so it will be saved. Now, so this is the reason master recently announced. So now you can mark, create the reason based on the transaction wise. So just click here. So you can give the name. So you can give the reason type here. So transaction name you can give here, for which transaction you are going to use this reason, so like sales. So you can give the reason, and you can make it active, and this one, and you can give the reason code also, and you can save it. So you can also use and practice this one, this reason master, screen wise, transaction wise, and send to outlet. Now just I'm going to explain you the bulk category insert. If you in the bulk category insert, yeah, whatever the categories, main categories available, you can create here in bulk from the Excel sheet. You can do the copy paste and it will be created. So just you go down and just do the copy paste. So you can create. So category, and you can save it. So in the same way, you can create multiple category like brand or whatever the category it is available, you can create here in bulk. So in the same way, you can create the item master in bulk also. So bulk item insert. So if you click here, so you can do the copy paste from the Excel sheet. You can enable the configuration. So what are the columns it is required? So you can enable, and you can create it here. So the good option is, we'll show you the encodemaster. That is encodemaster. So you can do the bulk add. So you give the bulk add. So you can update the existing encode. So if you want to delete any existing encode, you can delete it from here and save it. And if you want to add, so you can create new encode. So you can give the item code here. So you can give the encode, and you can give the rate of that items. And you can, if items contains the UM, you can also mark the UM also, and you can save it. So this is item encode create, and CSV file also upload also available. So you can download the template, you can fill, and you can update it from here. So encode you can update from here. Now I can explain you regarding the change selling. So this is very much important. So price management, change selling, price. Yeah. So this screen is open. So now you can give the item wise or category wise, you can give here. So you can choose the items. So advanced filter also available. So here you can do the CSV file import, like through item code or based on item code, based on the EN code. So batch wise also it can be done from Excel sheet. You can just click here, you can download the template, and you can import. So just I'm clicking for only one items here. So give here. So now you can give the new rate here, 60. So you can give here 60. Give here 60 also. So now it's save and continue. You can proceed. So now you can choose the all outlet, or you can select the specific outlet, save it. So once you save, now it will ask you, you can schedule the date, like which date you want to make it active. So I want on 18th. So you can give the time also. So as for your time, 6. So you can set and postpone. So now this is set. So this is called chain selling. Now I'll also give you some idea regarding the loyalty migration. So this is migration, loyalty migration. So you can choose the how you want to do the migration, like migration without card. So you can choose the what are the loyalty program it you are running. You can choose, and you can give the phone number and loyalty points available. You can do the migration with the card also. So here you can give the phone number, card number, and loyalty points available. So the same way, multiple options are available here. So you can do, and you can do the practice. So this is the basic features available for the supermarkets. So many more features available, and you can do the hands-on and practice. Yeah, thank you.